Everybody, thank you so much for coming to our panel, Always Keep Nerd Fighting, Fandoms and Social Movements. I'm Xena, Warrior Princess. Thank you. And this is my research partner, Easter, the goddess Easter from American Gods. Any American Gods? Yeah, come in, you're not late. Come on, it's fun. Come in. No? Never mind. Okay, goodbye. I'm kidding. You don't have to come in, no pressure. Actually, in real life, my name is Tanya Cook. I'm a sociology professor at the Community College of Aurora in Aurora, Colorado. And my research partner for this study is Kayla Joseph. And she is a clinical psychologist and instructor at the California Institute of Integral Studies. I finally said it right. Yay me. Okay, so thanks so much for coming. We have a great panel for you here today. So just to kind of give you a little tiny bit of background on this study, we are fans, as you can tell from us cosplaying and whatnot. As we are fans ourselves, we noticed a lot of charitable work and social activism happening in fandoms. And so we were kind of really curious about that, especially that we were seeing it multiple fandoms at the same time. Harry Potter Alliance is doing some excellent work with the Granger Leadership Academy. I'm sure you could tell me about things that you're doing, which I'd love to hear about. And what we're trying to do with this project is essentially answer the questions why, how, and when this activism is coming out of fandoms, and how it's similar to or different from historic social movements like the labor movement and the civil rights movement. So basically our question is, why is fandom becoming a vehicle to mobilize people for social action, specifically social justice kind of campaigns? All right. We're also interested in kind of what meaning fandom creates for fans and how that affects their identities. So our plan today is just to talk really, really briefly about what we've found out so far, and then we've prepared some questions for our panelists that they're going to respond to, and then the last little bit of the panel, we'll open it up for questions from you all, and there's some cards on your seat, so you might be able to get a prize, maybe? So don't lose your card. What? I know. Okay, so first, before we get started, let me introduce our excellent panelists. So when I say your name, just wave so they know who you are. So first we have Riley Keschner. Hey Riley, thank you for coming. And by the way, a lot of these people came from all the way to Denver from far away. So thank you so much. Riley's a graphic artist and half of the duo behind the very popular and very influential Twitter group, Wayward Daughters. So if anybody, yeah, right? Right? So, spinoff? Yeah? Yeah? So, we're going to talk about that, okay? So, together with Kim Rhodes, Brianna Buckmaster, and Betty Days, Wayward Daughters has run several charity campaigns to benefit Random Acts and New Leash on Life, among others. Welcome, Riley. Thanks so much for coming. Thank you. All right, down the table a little bit, we have Anita Moncrief, and she is a grassroots organizer and expert activist. Inspired by Supernatural's 200th episode, set in Flint, Michigan, she came up with the idea to sponsor a contest called Fanfic for Flint. So what they're going to do is have writers submit the full musical script, and then they're going to produce it with actors and everything. Has anybody seen Supernatural the musical? Yeah. Yes. So, and what they're going to do with the proceeds of that is they're going to help the people of Flint buy water filters to filter out lead, because these people have not had clean water for over 1,000 days. It's just not right. So we gotta do something about that, right? All right. Welcome, Anita. Thank you so much for coming. All right, and finally we have Jillian Holtzman, AKA Charlotte Renkin. Charlotte's my, full disclosure, my friend. So thanks, Charlotte. And she's a multimedia storyteller and journalist. She's an active member of the Colorado and London Nerdfighter groups, which are, who knows Nerdfighters? Yeah, John and Hank Green, all right, Vlog Brothers. Okay, awesome. And so she writes a lot about fandom, online community, literary activism, and she's the editor of the upcoming pop culture zine, Parallels in Fandom, which is accepting submissions until the end of July, right? All right, and full disclosure, we've got an essay coming out on that, so watch for that, about how awkward I get around Misha Collins. Okay? It's and amazing. Other stuff that's more important than that, but okay. Thanks, Charlotte. Welcome. Okay, so just a little bit of background. I started working on this in the fall of 2015 after falling headfirst in the Supernatural fandom and seeing all the great work fans were doing with Gishwiz. Everybody know what Gishwiz is? The greatest international scavenger hunt the world has ever seen. Okay, very, very modest name there. And Random Acts. But things really took off when Misha shared my conference abstract on his Facebook page and used it to troll Jared Padalecki about starting a cult. So I guess thank you, Misha. Yeah, thank you. So Kayla and I have interviewed over 20 people in the past 9 months who identify as fans. So I'm behind on slides. There we are. Okay, here's people we've talked to. So 20 people, more than 20, probably 24, 25 to date, spoken to bakers, archivists, writers, forensic toxicologists, teachers, stay-at-home parents, factory workers, call service representatives, you name it. And in the US, UK, and Canada, with one commonality, they love their fandom and they want to make the world a better place. So in general, most people we've spoken with look similar to us demographically, that is female. Look around the room, a lot of, I'm assuming, female-identifying people, maybe not, between 20 to 60, have a bachelor's degree or higher, and are mostly American of European descent. And then here's some of the fandoms that are represented in our studies. You can see a pretty broad range of fandoms. Most individuals, I would say, that we've talked to so far in the Supernatural fandom, probably followed by Star Wars, the 501st, and Rebel Alliance are quite active in charity work. Any Star Wars folks out there? All right, thank you. When we've asked fans how and why they do charity work and how they connect that identity to charity work, here's some commonalities that they've shared. They've been inspired by leaders, celebrity leaders in the fandom, so I would call this Misha, 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 or Jared, Misha, Jared, Misha, is the way I would summarize that. So I'm calling these kinds of leaders star-ticipants, because they actually participate in the charity work themselves. So it's not just, I'm going to ask you to do this thing, I'm going to go there with you and build this school. I'm going to do this with you, let's do this together. Fans have talked about wanting to give back to help other fans based on joy that they've received from the fandom, support they've received. I think Riley's gonna talk a little more about this, about the paying it forward aspect. And then fandom is a reciprocal or gift economy we're finding, and that's an anthropological term, but essentially fans trade art, they trade stories, they share things with other fans and support each other, and it's really inspiring. And finally, fans talk about wanting to create the world that they see in their fandom, like the best, idealized, most wonderful version that they can create that fandom world. So here's charities that fans have supported and done activism for that we've spoken with. Some of these are charities you, I'm sure, are familiar with, and others are individual fan charities that they've started themselves. And these are some of the quotes that fans have shared with us. So I'll just leave this up here. When I've asked about how and why does fandom membership inspire you to do charity work, social activism, this is what people have said. It's just amazing. So. Thank you. So I'm going to turn this over to Kayla to read out our questions and let the panelists respond. Thank you.
Thank you, Tanya. So our first question, we've gotten a little bit of background from all of you, but if you could just take a minute to describe your experience with your group or project and why this topic or project.